the mark of the beast. Will receiving the mark of the beast be a casual, everyday event, or will there be blood shed and death for the ones who wisely reject it? Will this be on a large scale? What are the circumstances surrounding the issuing of the mark of the beast? Is it possible one might take the mark by mistake? Can this mark be out now at this time in January 2008? Is the national ID card, social security card, or any card the mark of the beast as some seem to think? Let's carefully look at God's word and find the answers. The following scriptures are all of the verses cited in the New Testament which are related to the mark of the beast or the number of his name. Please ponder all nine of the following points carefully so you won't be misled. 1. The mark of the beast, which will be on or in the right hand or forehead, is needed to buy or sell things, and that mark will be forced on the people. He also forced everyone, small and great, rich and poor, free and slave, to receive a mark on his right hand or on his forehead, so that no one could buy or sell unless he had the mark, which is the name of the beast or the number of his name. This calls for wisdom. If anyone has insight, let him calculate the number of the beast, for it is man's number. His number is 666. Revelation chapter 13, 16 through 18. Comment. If you can buy or sell without a particular mark, then that mark cannot possibly be the infamous mark of the beast. Again, the location on the body of the mark of the beast is either the right hand or the forehead. It therefore cannot be any card that one would carry in his wallet, purse, or pocket. 2. The breathing, speaking image of the Antichrist will be worshipped by those who receive the mark of the beast, but those who refuse this idolatry will be put to physical death. Revelation chapter 13, verse 15 says, "He was given power to give breath to the image of the first beast so that it could speak and cause all who refuse to worship the image to be killed." 3. For those that make the spiritually fatal mistake of taking the mark of the beast, painful and ugly sores will break out on their body. The first angel went and poured out his bowl on the land, and ugly and painful sores broke out on the people who had the mark of the beast and worshiped his image. Revelation chapter 16, verse 2. Note, again we see that worshiping the image of the Antichrist is connected with receiving the mark of the beast. Hence, receiving such will not happen casually or by accident. 4. Through miraculous signs performed by the false prophet, people will be lethally deceived into taking the mark of the beast. The ones who take the mark will see these miraculous signs and worship the image of the Antichrist. But the beast was captured, and with him the false prophet who had performed the miraculous signs on his behalf. With these signs, he had deluded those who received the mark of the beast and worshipped his image. The two of them were thrown alive into the fiery lake of burning sulfur, Revelation chapter 19, verse 20. Comment. If a particular mark, which you think might be the real mark of the beast, doesn't have miraculous signs prompting people to take it, and issued when the Antichrist is here, then that same mark cannot be the infamous mark of the beast. 5. Not all people during the tribulation period will be deceived into taking the mark of the beast. Some people at this time will be beheaded or martyred because of their testimony for Jesus and because of the word of God. The Bible says, "I saw thrones in which were seated those who had been given authority to judge. And I saw the souls of those who had been beheaded because of their testimony for Jesus and because of the word of God. They had not worshipped the beast or his image and had not received his mark on their foreheads or their hands. They came to life and reigned with Christ 1,000 years, Revelation chapter 20, verse 4. Note, in Revelation chapter 12, verse 11, the overcomers gained victory in part by their own testimony. They overcame him by the blood of the Lamb, by the word of their testimony. They did not love the lies so much as to shrink from death. Revelation chapter 12, verse 11. According to Revelation chapter 7, 9 through 14, there will be a great multitude that no man can count in heaven just from the tribulation period alone. Here are the details as cited in Revelation chapter 7, verse 9. After this I looked, and there before me was a great multitude that no one could count, from every nation, tribe, people, and language, standing before the throne and in front of the Lamb. They were wearing white robes and were holding palm branches in their hands. 6. The ones who are victorious over the beast's image and his mark will stand in heaven by the sea of glass with harps and sing. And I saw what looked like a sea of glass mixed with fire, and standing beside the sea were those who had been victorious over the beast and his image and over the number of his name. They held harps given them by God and sang the song of Moses, the servant of God, and the song of the Lamb. Great and marvelous are your deeds, Lord God Almighty, just and true are your ways, King of the ages. Revelation chapter 15, 2 and 3. 7. Receiving the mark of the beast and worshiping the beast in his image is a sin that will lead to damnation, even for those who were previously saved. A third angel followed them and said in a loud voice, if anyone worships the beast in his image and receives his mark on the forehead or on the hand, he too will drink of the wine of God's fury, which has been poured full strength into the cup of his wrath. He will be tormented with burning sulfur in the presence of the holy angels and of the Lamb, and the smoke of their torment rises forever and ever. There is no rest day or night for those who worship the beast and his image, or for anyone who receives the mark of his name. This calls for patient endurance on the part of the saints who obey God's commands and remain faithful to Jesus. Revelation chapter 14, verses 9 through 12. Comment. A general worldwide warning from God will be given to all not to take the mark of the beast. All who ignore this advice and commit this sin, even former Christians, will go to the lake of burning sulfur, and there will be torment for them. Don't be deceived by eternal security. 8. The Antichrist will only rule for 42 months. Hence, the mark of the beast will enable those who take that mark, that amount of time or less, to buy and sell before their eternal damnation. 9. The beast and the false prophet, along with the devil himself, will be thrown into the lake of burning sulfur and will be tormented forever and ever. And the devil will deceive them, was thrown into the lake of burning sulfur where the beast and the false prophet had been thrown. They will be tormented day and night forever and ever. Revelation chapter 20, verse 10. Comment. 1,000 years after the beast and the false prophet are thrown into the lake of fire, the devil will also be thrown in. After 1,000 years in that place, the beast and the false prophet are not annihilated, but will continue to be tormented forever and ever. For those concerned about the national ID card issued here in the United States, remember, this is only for this country and not on a global scale, as the mark of the beast will be. The national ID card cannot possibly be the mark of the beast in light of all of the aforementioned details from God's word. Neither is it true that all Sunday worshipers of God will take the mark of the beast, as a Seventh-day Adventist founder and false prophet Ellen G. White wrongly taught. Jesus said, "The night is coming when no one can work." John chapter 9, verse 4. Let us all evangelize and faithfully serve God in a general way while we still can. The apostasy we are in now will only get worse as the Antichrist comes to the forefront. God bless you.